But I'm going to read one verse tonight, and for the young Christians, it's a wonderful verse to highlight. Chapter 18 of Proverbs, chapter 20, or verse 24. Chapter 18 and verse 24. A man that hath friends must show himself friendly. There is a friend that sticketh closer than a brother. And I'm not going to tell you what store I was in this afternoon. Tammy wanted me to pick up something for her. But right there in that store, I wanted to preach a little bit on this verse, Dave. It bugs me, and I worked in the public. I worked in retail for 40 years. I had four different jobs in retail. I worked one night at a restaurant, and I found out I wasn't no good at that. And the other three was in grocery stores. And I'm sure I wasn't the nicest one ever. But this one certain store that I have to go in sometimes, I'm telling you what, those poor people, I wish the company would give them a raise, because man, it seems like all they can afford to eat is razor blades and nails. They are very grouchy. And this girl today, I wanted to say, my goodness, if you hate your job that bad, get out of here, you know? And I was trying to be nice as I could. But when I was thinking that, when I got in the car, you know, and I was chomping at the bit, I thought, now, wait a minute, preacher. The Bible said if a man wants friends, he must show himself friendly. So I think that I was being nice. I was trying to be nice. But in other words, was I? Was I? Did I rub off? But the scripture goes on to say, and I'll read that first part again, a man that hath friends must show himself friendly. And the last part was what was on my mind Sunday night. And I believe that I quoted it, I quoted it and maybe tried to tell you where it was at. But anyway, said, but there is a friend that sticketh closer than a brother. And we quote that scripture so often. And I know everybody enjoys their friends. There's friends that, I know people that will meet somebody, Betty, and they'll meet them, and the very same day, they say, that's the best friend I've ever had. And they ain't known them 24 hours. Listen, you ever see somebody like that? Every time they turn around, they change friends more than they change socks. Yes, sirree. And they'll meet somebody that they never know, don't know nothing about. Automatically, that's my best friend. That's my best friend. But I tell you what, our brother wrote here, he said, there is a friend, Josh, that sticketh closer than a brother. And I found that friend in Jesus, haven't you? I found that friend in Jesus. In my grouchy days, like the girl, when I've acted like the girl in that store today, he's still my friend. Yes, sirree. When I've not been faithful to him, he's still been my friend. When I've not treated him, Dave, hallelujah, forever, he's still been my friend. Praise the Lord. Dave, I know that you come to the Lord in your old age, but still, thank God he was your friend all down through the years. Had he not been, you wouldn't have made it till the day you got saved. Now, if you were to ask me, before you had asked me Sunday, if you said, preacher, do you know what a friend is? I'd say, yeah, I know what a friend is. It's a pal, it's a buddy. It's somebody that's good to you. But y'all know me, It disturbs me and moves me to get the dictionary out. And I hope every one of you has got a dictionary in your house. First of all, I hope that you got a Bible. But there's a lot of words that I don't know the meaning of, especially these days. I'll have to ask a kid or somebody, I said, what's it mean? You know, a word about that long. But Brother Elmer, there's words we've used all of our life and never really know the definition. And I graduated from high school. It's been over 10 years now. And I didn't make real good grades, but I got a diploma. And this is one of the first words that I ever learned. But I got such a blessing, Josh, when I got Webster out and looked at it. Webster said, a friend is a person who one knows well or is very fond of. Yeah, Webster, you're right there. And Webster said, a friend, well, let's just stop here a minute. He said, a friend is a person one knows well or is very fond of. Man, I'm telling you what, just the more I learn about it. Yeah, do you ever see these kids and there's some grown-ups that talk, say, a kid will have a spat and they'll say, you ain't my friend no more. You know, over nothing, over a piece of candy or you ain't my friend no more. I'm gonna get me a new friend. And they'll go over and on the playground, Zach picked on Jenna. What was it they called that crew that gathered around on the breaks and right in front of Sherman High School, Josh, around that tree out there? I don't know, Zach get on dinner. Her and her friends get out there and there's a bunch of drama going on and he would get on them. He said, that ain't no kind of friend, but anyways, they say, you ain't my friend no more. But Webster said, a friend is a person one knows well, was very fond of. Webster said, a friend is a close acquaintance. Yeah, that's a friend, isn't it? Oh, but I liked it as he went on. Webster went on. He said, I ain't gonna stop here. He said, a friend is valuable if he's a person one knows well, is very fond of, or a close acquaintance. But Webster, I can just hear him. I hope he makes it to heaven. I want to talk to him. And I know he had a lot of help with these definitions. But I'm going to tell you, I'm glad that he didn't leave this out. Webster said a friend is a person on the same side in a struggle. Praise the Lord. I'm glad that I found my friend Jesus. Just when I was struggling, when I was beat down, I found him to be on my side. Bless the Lord forever. And the last one that I used at Webster give, the definition for a friend. Webster said a friend was a supporter and a sympathizer. Amen. Aren't you glad, Mary? Aren't you glad that the Lord supports you? When everybody else seems like it's gone, especially when we're having pity parties, feeling sorry for ourselves. And the Lord, listen, the Lord just said, just grow up. But he'd come every time, Josh, and support us, lift us up, and sympathizes with us. When he should spank our bottoms and say, why don't you grow up? Won't you get a grip? But Sister Karen, he supports us in our weaknesses. Does he uphold us in our wrong? No. But he knows each one. He knows each one. You mamas in the building, and I'll be the first to say, a mama understands her children a lot better than a daddy does. I found that out over the years. Listen, and my mother I've told this so many times. Jenna was behind in a lot of things when she was developing in her young years. She didn't crawl as fast as other kids did or as soon as other kids did. Her mobile skills were slow. And man, that physical therapist would come to our house, children therapy or whatever it was. Boy, we was helping that baby and we was supporting her. Tammy was doing everything she could. That woman, she'd shake her head and I wanted to squeeze it. And one night I called Mom and I said, Mom, I said, this woman, she just drags us down. I know she's sent here to help, but she just drags us down. And at that time she was working on something, I believe it was crawling with Jenna. Mom said, son, let me tell you one thing. She said, I raised 5 kids. None of them walked at the same time. None of them talked at the same time. None of them crawled. Said, everybody's different. And you got to learn to understand them. And boy, isn't that the way Jesus is. Thank God for him. He knows each one of us. Some of us might be strong in one area and weak in the other, or weak in one and strong in the other. But he sympathizes with each one of us, and he supports us, just like a good mom or dad. Aren't you glad that you can say, Solomon, you was right. Proverbs, you was right. I found that friend that sticketh closer than a brother. I found that friend that is true, that'll walk right by your side. That friend is Jesus. That friend is Jesus. If you're in the building tonight or you're viewing live stream, you say, preacher, I've had a lot of friends, but I ain't had a friend like that before. You can have him. He'll be anybody's friend. The Word of God teaches us that he's no respecter of person. And I found that to be true, haven't you? I found that he's no respecter of person. He treats me the same, no matter where we're at. He treats me the same, no matter who's around. He loves me.
What you do?
Do you ever have a, huh?
What you do, no matter what you do.
No matter what you do? Yeah. Do you ever have a friend that you really thought he was your friend, but when other people come around, they kind of, that don't feel good, does it? But you know what? I'm telling you, I've been in places before. I've been in churches before. The preacher's far greater than I could ever preach. And more well-known. And I'd be so intimidated. But you know what? The same anointing that touched them fell on me. This old poor country preacher, he supports me just like he does the Billy Grahams and all of them. And we're all equal in his eyes. Isn't that a good friend to have, church? So listen, when you're feeling down and out, when you're feeling blue, you can say, I got a friend that sticketh closer than a brother. Father, we come before you tonight, and we're so thankful for you being our friend. So thankful, Lord, that you sympathize with us, Lord. You even listen to us, Lord, when we don't make sense. Lord, you even take time for us, Lord, when we're not even worth your time, Lord. And I praise you for being a friend like that. A friend that sticketh closer than a brother. And I'm telling you what, I know that blood is thick, and kinfolks is thick, and kinfolks will stand by you when nobody else will. Most of the time. But I know one thing, Lord, you're closer and you'll stick closer than a brother. And I thank you for that. Somebody tonight listening to me, Lord, needs a friend. Somebody needs a sympathizer. Somebody needs a supporter, even in the midst of a struggle. And Lord, I pray right now, Lord, that you would help them to reach out to you. And Lord, that they would just say, Lord, I need a friend. I need a friend. And Lord, help them to realize tonight that the only way, Lord, that you can be there with them is if they claim you as their friend. And in order for them to claim you as their friend, they've got to say, Lord, I want you to be my Savior. I want you to be my Master. And I want you to be Lord of my life. I repent of all that I've done wrong. And I'm sorry for all of my sin. And I need a friend tonight. I need a Savior. Help them, Lord. Help them, Lord, to pray that prayer. Lord, help them to plead with you. Your word teaches us that no way you would in no wise cast anyone out that called on your name. For your word said, for whosoever shall call upon the name of the Lord shall be saved. So give them courage right now. Whether in this building, or whether they're viewing live stream, give them courage. But Lord, after that, help them to stand. Help them to get on that keypad. Help them to tell somebody, say, hey, I got a new friend, and that's Jesus. I've been saved and I've been set free. In Jesus' name I pray. Amen. All right, if you prayed that prayer, let us know. Let somebody know. We don't want you bragging on us, telling us it wasn't us. If you truly got saved, it wasn't us. It was God spoke to your heart. We can't save you, but he can. Listen as they sing this song.
What would I do without Jesus, the shepherd of my valley? I couldn't walk this road down hill alone. And it seems all the world.